Dr. Eleni Melliou, who's done tremendous work on the analysis of olives, especially, and she's going to present her work on the health benefits of olives and the effect on cholesterol. Eleni Melliou, please.
Good afternoon. My presentation is about the health benefits of olives and the latest research on the effect on cholesterol. The olive tree belong to oleaceae family. The olive fruit and the olive oil have a dominating position in the agriculture, the nutrition, and the traditional medicine of many countries, especially around the Mediterranean. The roots of olive cultivation go back to 5000 BC. The cultivation of the olive tree was extensively expanded to the European continent, and for this reason, it was named as Elia η Ευρωπαϊκή or Olea Europaea. The Greek history and mythology is closely related with olive productions, as you can see on the slides, especially in the city of Athens, was considered to be the first place in the world where the olive tree gave any fruit, according to the legend of goddess Athena, who gave for a gift to Athenians the olive tree. And the Athenians gave the name of goddess Athena to the Athens city. And on the slides, you can see photos from the fresco of Knossos Palace. And you can see on the frescoes olive trees. And of course, there they found also olives, Asian olives in Asian jars. The olive cultivation and production, the olive tree is cultivated in 40 countries around the world. World production is about 17 million tons. It's mainly cultivated in the Mediterranean basin, 98% of the world production, and Greece covers the 14% of the world productions. Among the olives varieties, some are used for olive oil production and some for consumption after debittering, and we call them table olives. The world production of table olives is about 1.5 million tons. Greece, Greeks' production of table olives is about 100,000 tons, and the consumption increase is about 30,000 tons. The rest are exported. The main compound that we can find in the olive fruit is the bitter compound oleopein. And the molecule you can see on the slides. When we want to produce table olives, we have to debittering the olives. So the target of the debittering process is to hydrolyze or remove by diffusion the oleuropein, the bitter compound, from the flesh of the fruit, either partially or completely. For this, there are two major processes. One is by to use an enzyme, esterase, to hydrolyze the molecule of olaropein and produce some compounds that are not a bitter, or to use water or brine, dry salt, or lye. Lye is a solution of sodium hydroxide in water, 1 or 2%. According to the followed the bittering method for table olives, we have the according styles. The natural black olives is about 45% of all of the styles that we have. Natural black in brine, Greek style, we say this style of olives. And in this style, we have fermentation in brine for 3 until 6 months. The other style, very famous, is the green Spanish style. In this style, we have treatment with lye and fermentation in brine for 3-4 weeks. We have the other style is the black California style. In this kind of style, we have treatment with lye and oxidation with iron salts to make the black color. And the other style is the dry salted Thruba type, common in Greece. And olives and this kind of olives are produced by dry salt in layers for 20 until 60 days until the bittering. And the olives are dehydrated and not fermented, obtaining a wrinkled surface, as you can see on the slide. On the table olives, there are many phenolic compounds, like olaropein, hydroxytyrosol, and tyrosol. These compounds have very good properties, like antioxidants, anti-inflammatory, anti-thrombotic activity, and they are also antimicrobial. They have also antimicrobial properties. So now, some years ago, it was found that olaropein had anti-ischemic, antioxidant, and hypolipidemic activity in rabbits. The orally administered dose corresponding to a human dose of 50 gram olive oil or 15 table olives. Here on the slides you can see the olaropein reduces the size of the myocardial infraction in healthy rabbits, and at higher dose in hypercholesterolemic rabbits. And here you can see that olaropein can reduce also the level of total cholesterol. Another very powerful antioxidant and phenolic compound is hydroxytyrosol. Several formulations contain hydroxytyrosol are already in the market as food supplements and cosmetics. The use of phenol compounds from olive fruit we can use these phenol compounds in pharmacology, cosmetology, and as additives to enhance the beneficial properties of another food. And additional olive fruit under specific conditions can be a functional food. The olive fruit can be a functional food under specific conditions. One part of our study, it was to developed methods for the quantification of the main antioxidant or of bioactive compounds of table olives and comparison of the effect of the debittering method. For this reason, we found a method to measure for quantitative measurement of oleuropein to quantitative quantitative measurement of hydroxy tyrosol and also a simultaneous measurement of 15 bioactive compounds. So we select 9 olive varieties from supermarket samples, bulk or packed, and we apply our method. Oh, sorry. I will not say a lot about chemical method, but only I will mention that by HPLC method, we managed to measure oleuropein and hydroxytyrosol in the olive fruit. As you can see, these are in the on the slides two HPLC chromatogram, and we found through bathassos. Varieties through bathassos from Greece, we found the major compound was oleuropein, and in Kalamata olives, the major compound was hydroxytyrosol. And here you can see the other varieties that we studied, and that Kalamata olives contains high levels of hydroxytyrosol, and through bathassos, among the other varieties, contains high amount, high concentration of oleuropein. Then we study a variety that we have in around Athens region and in island that I live in Salamina, Megaritiki variety. The olive oil from Megaritiki variety, as Prokopios said before, has low polyphenol content. The fruit has low oleuropein content during the harvest time. We believe that this variety had a different, a possible metabolic differentiation. And as you can see in the photo, you can see NMR spectra there, and with the blue lines you can see the molecule of oleuropein, and the other is unprocessed fruit, the fresh fruit. You can see that there is no oleuropein in the unprocessed fruit, and at the edible fruit, in the table olives, the level of oleuropein is not exist, as you can see in the spectra. So in our lab, we try to produce table olives from megaritic varieties, and we harvest them around November from Salamina Island, and the production was according to a traditional debittering method using only water for 6 days. And every day we change the water. And then maintains in the brain 10% in the brain we can maintain these table olives. So from then we analyzed the table olives that were produced in our lab, and we discover a new compound from agaritic varieties. This is a series of four new compounds that we give them the name megaritolactones, and it's totally new. And we try now to see the biological activities of these new compounds. And the very good things is that also in the water, the debittering water contain also very good compounds. Contains high phenolic contents, and it's very useful, the debittering water. And we measure the levels of these compounds in the debittering water, and we found hydroxytyrosol, tyrosol, and others very good for our health phenols. So, and the waste are good. Then I continue my research in California, and I try to see if the Thruba from Thasos, this variety, has the highest amount of oleuropein. So I went to the supermarket in California, I bought olives from there, and I found a similar type of olives that they produced in California. Mission variety it was, and they produce something like dry salt that we can apply in Greece. And they bought these two types of olives, and then I developed a new method by UAPLC MSMS, a very new method, to analyze 12 compounds from table olives in less than 10 minutes. And I analyzed all of these compounds. I found in the table olives all of these compounds. And as you can see, the conclusion of this research that was performed in California is that the comparison you can see here between dry salt and California style olives, as you can see, the conclusion is that Thruba Thasos, which can produce by dry salt, contains the highest levels of oleuropein in compare with the others. Styles, because these compounds are very water soluble, and when you use water to debittering olives, you lose a lot of compounds, the good phenolic compounds. For this reason, I found this content of oleuropein only in dry salt, because in dry salt style we don't use water. So for all of this, like olive oil and the same, and in olive fruit, all the olives are not the same, as you can see for the research. And then I would like to continue with the effect of Kalamata type olives consumption on lipidemic profile of healthy volunteers. Cardiovascular diseases are the number one cause of death globally, as you know. an estimated 17 million people died from cardiovascular diseases in 2012, representing 31% of all global deaths. Of these deaths, an estimated about 7 million were due to coronary heart disease. So high consumption, as you know now, of olive oil has been associated with low incidence of coronary heart disease in Mediterranean countries. And we have a lot of research about the effect of olive oil to the cardiovascular diseases, as you can see. But I will not say a lot of atherosclerosis because Procopios said a lot about LDL and HDL, cholesterol. And you know a lot about that now, I think. So what about olives now? What about Greek olives? Does olives affect the lipidemic profile? Which olives? Which substance of olives? Hydroxytyrosol, as I said before, is a phenolic compound that is found in virgin olive oil, but also in table olives. And we choose olives. We analyzed 30 types of olives of Greek origin by NMR, and we select the best one to do some clinical trial to healthy humans. As you can see, we choose 20 healthy humans, and we give the table olives for a consumption. The study was like that. The 22 volunteers, the 0 day we take, we receive their blood, and we did a biochemical test for baseline. We gave them to consume for 30 days the table olives that which contain 25 milligram hydroxytyrosol per day. They ate 5 olives per day, the volunteers, for 30 days. And then at the end of the 30 days, we did biochemical test, and then for 30 more days, we had washout, not olive consumption. And after 30 days, we did in their blood a biochemical test. And what we saw is that from all the olives that we analyzed, the better olives, the best olives, were from Eleonis Sakellaropoulou. And the selected commercial olives contained 5 times higher phenols than the average supermarket samples. And here you can see the analyzed by NMR. And as you can see, at the end, I will go to the conclusion. I don't want to make you tired about all of these things. The conclusion after 30 days of the consumption is that we have effect to the lipidemic profile, and probably these compounds that we found in Kalamata olives contribute to the reduction of cardiovascular disease. And we continue now with a new ongoing research We have 100 volunteers with high cholesterol now, not healthy like before, and we continue, and we have great results from all of this ongoing study. We have seen reduction of the cholesterol also in the not health volunteers. We have seen that the reduction to the volunteers that has high cholesterol, not healthy volunteers. Okay, and at the end is the another research that I did in California, in UC Davis, and it's about olive debittering. There I found a new method how to debittering olives without sodium hydroxide, without lye, and what I did, I used a specific resins, adsorption resins, XAD type. As you can see, the photo is the chemical type. And this kind of resins has capable to selectively absorbs phenolic compounds from aqueous media. This is this in the slides. You can see how can work this kind of resins. The more you can see in the green color is the let's say the olive the phenol compounds, and you can see the olive skin, and we have we can bring in contact the resins with the olives, and the resins can absorb all of these bitter compounds from the olives, and we achieve the bittering without sodium hydroxide or lye. And the most good things, this is the good process diagram. The good things is that all of this can recycle everything of this process, because the resins containing adsorbed phenolics, you can then regenerate the resins by treatment with ethanol, and you can use again the resins, and also from the resin you can take all the good phenols and to use it, the phenols to cosmetics, to everything, for supplements, and I think. And then I developed a new method how to monitor all of this to the table olives. By LC-MS on NMR, you can see the levels that you have in the olives, and also to the water, to the water, the waste waters. And here you can see some examples. I applied this method, the new method, in manzanilla olives from California. The olives were harvested in the end of November. The olives were separated to black and green, and were treated for 15 and 30 days respectively with the specific resin. At the end of the olives were extracted according to the usual method and analyzed by NMR. The results are presented in the next slide, and show the impact of the resin on the final debittered fruit. As you can see here, the red green manzanilla untreated after 30 days, and the blue color is green manzanilla treated with resin for 30 days. You can see that they don't contain phenols. And here another spectra. And here. And here you can see a spectra. This is an analysis of an extract coming from the washing of resin with methanol. After contact with black manzanilla olives for 15 days, the resin indeed absorbs big quantities of phenolic and saccharidoids from the resins. So we can have also all the good polyphenols. The above procedure is protected by a world patent issued to the University of California, Davis. It is the first method in the world permitting the debittering of olives without water, without salt, without lye. And now it's a very innovative method that now has been licensed to a very big American olives company. Thank you for your attention, and I hope not that tired you. Okay, thank you.
I'll tell you.